So, for he,
you're worthy
to be praised.
Oh, magnify the Lord.
Magnify the Lord.
For he is worthy.
For he is
come
worthy
on, say
to
it one more
praised.
Time.
Welcome you to the services here at Southeast Seventh-day Adventist Church.
Yeah.
I am welcoming everyone here in the sanctuary, everyone on the streaming platforms, everyone on the social media platform, because we are here this morning to give God some glory, to give God some honor, to give God some praise, because God is worthy. Is he worthy? Is he worthy? Is he worthy? Is he worthy? Yes, he is. Bless your name, Jesus. I welcome you to to be with us on this morning. I'm glad you are here. And I am here, they have already done it, but I'm here to officially give you a welcome this morning. And I'm here to officially let you know we are here in the hour of prayer on this morning. We are here on the hour of giving God all the glory, all the honor, all the praise. This is your call to worship. Reading and your hearing this morning from the first division of Psalms, the 37th number. Fret not thyself because of evildoers. Neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the grass hath. Trust in the Lord and do good. So shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord. Delight thyself also in the Lord. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of your heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday. Rest in the Lord, and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any way to do evil, for evildoers shall be cut off, but those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he doth delight in his way. Though he shall fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. I have been young, and now I am old, and I can say that for a fact. I have been young, and now I am old. Yet, I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. He is ever merciful and lendeth, and his seed is blessed. Depart from evil and do good, and dwell forevermore. For the Lord loveth judgment, and forsaketh not his saints. They are preserved forever, but the seed of the wicked shall he cut off. Let us all stand for the reading of the fourth commandment. Let us begin. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work. For the Lord is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt do any work, thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor the cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea and all that in them is, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Father God, in the mighty and precious name of Jesus, God, I give you praise, glory, and honor on this morning. God, I lift you up on high because you are worthy of all the praise. You are worthy of all the glory. You are worthy of all the honor, oh my God. I'm asking you, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you would bless us, your people, in your house on today. Lord, those that are on the internet, God, those on the social media platforms, let everyone, Lord, within the sound of my voice, let them be blessed on today. Today is the holy day. Today is the Sabbath day. Today is the day of rest. And God, we come this morning to fellowship with you. Just as you walked with Adam and Eve in the garden, God, you are walking with us on this day. Lord, all we have to do is open ourselves up unto you, and Lord, we will feel your presence, oh God, in the name of Jesus. So I'm asking, God, that you move in this congregation. Move on each and every one of us, Father, so that, Lord, we can feel your presence in this building. Let your anointing flow, and let our hearts and our minds be receptive unto your word on today. In the mighty and precious name of Jesus, I do ask and pray. Amen and amen. Let us stand, remain standing for our hymn this morning.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. For our morning hymn this morning is On the Old Rugged Cross. Mm-hmm. help me say it.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross.
The emblem.
Thank you so much. Happy Sabbath, everyone. It looks a little cloudy in here. Amen. I'm glad you made it in here safely this morning. And I want you to know that we are monitoring things to make sure that everybody is going to be all right. But what we're monitoring is this location. And this location that simply says rain and thunderstorms. What I need you to do right now is pull out your phone and see what's happening at your house and your area, because you might have to make some decisions. And I don't want to put you in harm's way. If you have to go early or you need to stay by and wait for the storm to pass, I ain't going to take that personally, because I'd rather you be safe than anything else. So it might be one of the only times we tell you to look at your phone. Look at what's happening in your area where you are. I know that some tornado warning sirens have gone off, but I checked out what's happening over here, and we're all right here. So I pray that you are all right wherever your home is, and if you have to stay by a little longer and wait for the storm to pass, then amen. Amen, amen. But I want you to do that. It's going to be a little bumpy for the rest of the day, but God has got us through a lot of storms, right? Amen, amen. And for the cause of safety, I am canceling the activities that were scheduled for after church, because I want you to go home. I want you to go home. And if you go home and say, "Pastor, nothing happened," then praise the Lord. At least you were at home when nothing happened. Amen. Amen. But we want you to go home and be safe if you can. Now, if you look in and the storm is over your house, then stay here or go home with somebody else until you can safely do that. Everybody good on that? All right, so we're going to go ahead and I believe God. See, it's just right in front of you. Believe. I believe God. So we're going to go ahead with the service. It may not be as long as it normally is, but that's not because we're afraid or we're unsafe. We're just cautious. That's all. That's all. I have a letter here from Sister Rachel Brown in behalf of her late husband, Warner. She says, Southeast Seventh-day Adventist Church to Pastor Stan Hood, Sister Elisa Hood, church board, members, and friends, on behalf of the family of Warner L. Brown Sr., I would like to thank you for your thoughtfulness, acts of kindness, expressions of sympathy, and love. We appreciate each and every one of you. Please keep me in and our family in prayer. Humbly submitted, our dear Sister Rachel Brown. Amen, amen. And I said to her on the way in, welcome back. And remember when Warner passed, I said, you know, be careful with her. You know, don't bombard her. And so I'm going to ask it again today. I remember when my mother passed, people were just trying to be nice. But sometimes you take people back to a place they don't want to go by over and over and over again telling them you're so sorry. All right, so she knows that you are sorry. She knows that you love her. So treat her like you would any other day. Amen, amen, and amen. All right, so have just a couple of announcements. You see the April sermon series. Want to remind you about our activity for men's ministry that's happening on the boat in June. What's the name of that boat we going on? What's the name of the boat? The Nautica. Somebody said the Good Time, and somebody said the Nautica. Okay, get on the one all the rest of Southeast members getting on, and you'll be in good shape. Amen. But if you don't have your tickets, please, please hurry up and take care of that as soon as you can, so that everything will be all right. Okay, so I want to make sure I mention that. And also, we want to thank you for attending. We had a strong attendance at our family meeting on last Sunday. And you know how I can tell? Not just that day, I can see it online, but I see a lot of people without their mask on. You feel good? You feel better? Yes. Amen, amen. I'm glad you feel better in Jesus' name. He beat the drum on that one. Praise the Lord. Amen, amen. We want to thank our medical team for not just what they have done, but what they are continuing to do to make sure that they keep us safe. I just want you to know that you are welcome to make your choice whether to wear it or not wear it. But if you start hacking and coughing, we're going to come put one on your face. Amen. 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 I think I'm good. My little grandson left yesterday. You know, I called him a little germ. I started feeling better immediately. And so hopefully I'll be all right by the time it's time to preach. We're going to go ahead with the service. Please open your e-bulletin. Everything you need to know is in your e-bulletin. If you don't get it, then you need to let us know that you're not getting it. We had a little technical difficulty. Are we live? Are we live yet? Are we not live? Well, we're not live. Okay. All right. So we're not live because of the storm. So if you want friends and family to see the service, you're going to have to pull out your phone and go live yourself. And we'll just keep it moving in Jesus' name. All right. We're going to bring the praise team back. And we're going to see you again in just a moment.
Way back home.
Tell you, I've said it 3 or 4 times already, but Bernadette, I gotta say it again. Lord have mercy. There's been a shift in the atmosphere.
Hallelujah.
And for the good, praise the Lord for that. Amen. I want to thank our communications team. You have no idea how many hoops they jumped. They're gonna need a nap after this. They have been through quite a bit this morning trying to get things together. And we always appreciate our officers for taking good care of us. You may not notice because they're working around you, but the Lord is working. Amen, amen. One thing I forgot to mention is that Sabbath School Rewind begins on next Sabbath, meaning that at 11 o'clock, you know, we're going to continue to do what we do on Friday night, but on 11 o'clock on Sabbath morning, there's a review of the Sabbath School lesson right here in the sanctuary from 11 to 11:45. Amen, amen. And we have some other things in development. We'll let you know when it's ready. But for now, we want to start this new series, Believe. I know I didn't sing happy birthday to you, but we're going to do that next week. Okay? We're in Romans chapter 10, if you would stand with me, if you don't mind. Romans chapter 10, verses 17 and 18. We're going to read it together. I think I have all King James today. All King James. Oh, man, I'd love to see the house full on a rainy day. That means you are intentional about getting to the house of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. All right, y'all ready? I don't see nobody. Oh, wait on the head elder. I'm waiting on you. You got it? All right. I have to wait on the head elder there. All right, let's begin. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. But I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily, their sound went into all the earth, and their words unto the ends of the world. The first message of the series, Believe, Mike, is called, It's on the Record. It's on the record. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for safe traveling mercies. We trust, Lord, that you can still the storm until we return to our dwelling places. Keep us safe and all of those who are on the road. Bless the word today. Let it come forth mightily and powerfully to the conviction and conversion of souls is our prayer in Jesus' name. Let everyone say amen and amen. Amen. Okay, last one. I built this announcement right into the message. And this is, we talked about it last night. We're going to begin a fast 40 days before the tent effort. We're starting 40 days. That puts that at April 8th, next Sabbath evening at sunset. That's when the fast begins, next Sabbath evening at sunset. Okay, so let me break it down to you. That's why I told you, open your e-bulletin so you would see this. And then, of course, we're going to print some as we get closer. First thing I want to tell you is that's not a beer can up there on the screen. That is a soda can. I just didn't want to give Pepsi or Coke no free advertisement. But that is a soda can. Bless you, bless you, bless you in Jesus' name. Okay, the first 10 days of the fast are easy. All you got to do is give up your favorite treat. That's all you got to do. First, for 10 days, give up your favorite treat. You know what it is. It might be sweet. It might be whatever. That's all we're asking. And the reason we're starting that way is to get you in the mindset of fasting. It's to move us all into the mindset of fasting. And then for the next 10 days, we're going to continue fasting from our favorite treat, but we're going to also give up sugary drinks. That's why that can is there. And they give up sugary drinks. I know kids are like, what? Yeah, we're going to the water. My kids used to call it Jesus juice. That's what we're going to drink. We're going to the water. And then we're going to continue to do that the next 10 days. We're going to stop eating after 6, from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. And that's not too bad. You know, old school fast, you don't eat nothing. Nothing. Now, 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. And then, of course, the last 10 days, we will add on top of all those other things, the meat out challenge. No flesh foods for the 10 days leading up to the tent effort. Now, I tried to do this in such a way, I got some advice. so that it would be so we all could do it. I don't want to make nobody a liar over these 40 days of fasting. So I tried to do it where we could do it. And so I believe this is a good plan. Now, for those who already don't eat meat, then you got to find yourself a different challenge for the last 10 days. I'll leave that to you. But I want to show you on the orange line there, on day 21 to 30, the prayer warriors are going beyond no eating after 6 p.m. to 6 a.m., but we're going to cut the TV off. Amen. That's the prayer warriors. Now, we're going to do it. Now, if you want to join us, we'll be happy for you to join us, but there's no shame if you can't do it. Okay? But I will give you this tidbit. I have done this before, and the TV don't help because there's nice, juicy food commercials every 5 minutes. Okay? So cutting off the TV might help you. Amen. You get the best sleep of your life if you're not eating from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. The best way to get through a fast is to go to sleep. And when you wake up, praise the Lord, we can eat. Amen. Then for the meat out, the last 10 days, the prayer warriors are not just turning the TV off. We're going to turn off social media. Unless it has something to do with our spiritual growth and development, we're not posting, we're not watching, we're not reading. That's the prayer warriors. Now, you can join us if you like. By that time, you'd be about 30 days in. You might be too weak to see the words on the page. So you may not have a choice but to join us, but thank God for that. Now, the last thing I want to say, and then this is not a long message. Last thing I want to say is that if you are taking any kind of medication, then you need to consider that. You may need to augment this. You may not be able to participate in part of this. But you need to consult your doctor if you're not sure, because we don't have the money for your lawsuit. So I'm telling you right now, you need to consult your doctor. You ain't coming up on the church. You just gonna be mad, okay? So make sure that your health is good, all right? All right, so let's get to Romans chapter 10, verse 13 says, "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." All right, so what I see there, Elder Parker, is that there is no wiggle room for what happens or what's declared in this text. Whosoever shall call. Now, I want to qualify the word call. Some people call because they're scared. Some people call because they feel bad. Some people call because they got caught. No, it's not. It's like when you're raising your kids and they're just whining, you don't come because you know they're whining. But when they show enough hurt and they call you, a parent knows the difference. And trust and believe, if a parent knows the difference, then God knows the difference. Amen and amen. So those who heart cry out to God and sincerely want to be delivered, the Lord says, if you call me, you shall be saved. All right, well, let's qualify saved. Saved, God does in two different ways. Saved may be to deliver you from a car accident, to deliver you from a sickness, to deliver you from tragedy or hurt feelings. He usually does it that way, to deliver you from trouble. And then also he wants to seal us until redemption. That's a different kind of saved, all right? But God does not say in this verse that you get either or. If you call, you get what you need. Oh, I feel my help coming on here. Verse 14 says, "Then how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed?" Series title, Believe. "And how shall they believe in whom they have not heard?" Okay, so you have to hear in order to believe. Come on with me now. You have to hear in order to believe. Okay, well, how are we going to hear without a preacher? Amen. Verse 15 says, "And how shall they preach except they be sent?" So the preacher got to hear the voice of the Lord. "As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good news. Amen, amen. But we ain't done. Verse 16, but they have not all obeyed the gospel. Uh-oh. So just because you heard it doesn't guarantee your salvation. You can hear it, but you have to attach faith and belief to the hearing. Okay? For Esaias said, Lord, who have believed our report? So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Now I have a question for you. Let's talk about what we hear. Some of the things that we listen to prevent us from being able to hear the Holy Spirit. Uh-huh. Oh, yes. I feel the kids getting tight. I'm coming down your lane. First, let's talk about how we hear. You know that thing called our ears, this the outer portion of the ear, like satellites. If you're not sure if I'm telling the truth, you just cup them and move them forward and you'll hear differently. You put them back in place, you hear differently. But before we talk about hearing, let's talk about what we hear. What is sound? Anybody know what sound is? Sound is shifting vibrations moving in the atmosphere. Even when we listen to these speakers right now, there's something shifting. There's something moving inside of the speakers that amplify it out to you. So there's waves in the air moving and shifting until they reach your eardrum. Down the ear canal to your eardrum, and your eardrum begins to beat. Boom, boom, boom. It amplifies what it hears 22 times louder than the way it came in. And then the smallest little bones that are in your body are in the middle ear. And those little bones receive the message from the eardrum, and they're sending Morse code to your inner ear. Tap, 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 tap. And that Morse code is identified by a field of fibers inside your ear that sit next to a field of hair. The fibers shake and the hair interprets, and the hair makes the sound into words that we can understand and sends it to the brain. Uh-huh. And all that happens without you even thinking about it. Don't tell me you ain't never seen a miracle. A miracle is happening inside of you. That vibration, that shaking in the atmosphere operates on different frequencies. Whatever frequency it operates on will dictate your response. For instance, if you hear a creepy frequency, you're going to get a creepy feeling, right? If you anticipate a comforting frequency, then you get a comforting feeling. That's why it's good to play nice music to children while they're in the womb. Scientists say that even at 20 weeks, they began to develop their taste for music based on your taste for music. And once that taste is sealed, it is extremely difficult to change it. So if you listen to symphony or orchestra music, the IQ of that child is guaranteed to go up at least 9 points. That'll work right there. But if you try to start it later, it can be done, but it will be more difficult. Same thing with languages. That's why kids pick up languages easier earlier, between 1, 2, 3 years old. They pick up language no matter what it is. Yet later on in life, they have trouble with foreign languages because we're not as open and we're not that sponge the way we were when we were little kids. Okay? All right. Y'all asleep yet? Amen. Because I'm going somewhere with this. Let's talk about our range of hearing. Humans can hear sound frequencies in the range of 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Amazing. Age and damage reduces the upper limit. For example, an old person or someone exposed to prolonged high sounds, such as soldiers and so forth, that hearing is diminished. However, we have a large range of hearing. A dolphin can go up to 100 hertz. A dog can go from 40 to 60,000 hertz, depends upon the breed. So why are we talking about this? It's because people love music. Been that way since the beginning of time. 1 Samuel 16 tells us that David was called to play a spirit or sing a spirit out of Saul. So music has healing qualities. Music also can do damage. Music enforces or reinforces the memory. For instance, if I put it to a song, such as the Song of Moses, people will remember it forever. Even if they hadn't sang it in years, they'll remember it forever. God is a man of war. He took down the rider and his chariots. Doesn't matter how long it's been, you'll remember it. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. You'll finish it right now. And you haven't practiced it in years. However, it is embedded. All right. So that's why they spend so much money making these jingles for commercials. You say, well, music don't bother me. I'm just listening to the beat. It's just the soundtrack of my life. Walter Pearson used to say that all the time. It's the sound. It's the backdrop of my life. But that's not true. You know, they came up with this theory about left brain and right brain, and it's a simplistic view. Doctors have figured out that it's far more complicated than that now, but it still makes the point. Left brain and right brain, we function with one of them in our conscious mind, and the other part is our subconscious. It's recording in the background, and then it interprets and reproduces it in your sleep while you're resting. What you didn't hear consciously in the background plays back to you in your sleep. Yeah, that's deep, ain't it? Mm-hmm. So different frequencies do different things. Okay. Hey, almighty quiet. You're looking at me real hard. You wondering if I'm coming for your music? Different frequencies do different things. Jazz has such a wide variety within it. We can't really qualify the tempo of that, but the rest of it we can. Disco, you know, he said, well, listen to no disco no more. No, yesterday's disco is today's gospel. It's raining. You might as well just relax. Hip-hop is at 110 to 140. It reaches those lower regions. That's why your hips get to swinging. It's to hit those lower regions. And pop is that workout music. It gets you the eye of the tiger. It's the thrill of the fight. You ready to sing it now, ain't you? Rising up, you ready. And house music make people run into each other. I don't know why nobody listened to that. And then, of course, the drum and the bass on its own has, you see, it has its own frequency that it speaks to. You can appreciate this. C major makes you happy. It says gay and warlike, but gay here means happy. All right, just want to make that clear. C minor, obscure and sad. Frequencies do things to you. D major can make you cruel and quarrelsome, want to argue. D minor, make you serious and reflective. E major, cruel and hard. And then it goes on. Minor, effeminate, amorous, plaintive. Then F, furious and quick-tempered. F minor, obscure and plaintive. Don't you think people know this? If they're going to invest billions of dollars into music, then they're going to make sure it does what they want it to do. Amen. Amen. I didn't understand that baby talk music, you know, when they whining like little, mumbling like little babies. But even if you don't understand the words consciously, the other part of your brain does understand it. And then it reinforces it in your sleep, and you can wake up mad and ain't nobody did nothing to you. You wake up laughing and ain't nobody told no jokes. You can wake up tired or you can wake up energetic. It depends on what you hear is what I'm trying to say. All right. So I want to go on a little further. All right. Y'all sleep yet? There's colors attached to sound. Now, I don't have time to get all into that today. And quite frankly, I think I would mess it up anyway, Jan, but I'm going to try it anyway. There are colors attached to frequency. You know, people say, well, I don't know what happened. I just blacked out or whatever may go down. These things are all measured together. Let's talk about a few things that happens with colors and think about your favorite place to eat or your favorite place to patronize. Red means urgent. Yellow means happy. Green means fresh. Think about that. Blue means secure. Orange, excited. Purple, creative. Gray, balanced. Black, serious. All these things are working against you. We even go even further. When people are put under examination, if you could see by temperature, anger has us hot. You see that on the left there? Fear burns in our heart. Then disgust has a cold. Happiness has a cold. Sadness has us dark. Surprise, look at them eyes. You know, neutral, nothing. Anxiety. See, all these different moods that we have, they have colors. And so I'm only talking about this because I wanted to get to this part right here. How we worship matters. How we worship matters. Who we allow to lead us in worship matters. Who we allow to touch instruments matters. Light and darkness can't have anything to do with one another. We can't say because of the gift, I'll overlook the darkness. Oh, it's getting tight up in here now. Oh, it's getting tight up in here now. Lord, have mercy. I got to preach it. Because God says it. Some of us can't hear the Lord. We can't hear the altar call because the music is taking us in a place where God is not. Mm-hmm. Yes. So the Bible says that the fear of the Lord or respect for the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And how can you fear the Lord if you can't feel the presence of the Lord or you can't hear the Lord because you're distracted or captivated or yoked up or soul tied to something that God does not approve of? I'm so glad that in this temple, in this house, that I don't have to battle with the musicians to get the control of the service back. Because, you know, you go to some churches, once the musician got it, ain't nobody studying the pastor. So I'm glad today that I don't have to fight with the person on the keys to get the tempo or atmosphere of the church back. I'm glad today that I don't have to wrestle the lead psalmist. I don't have to take off a shoe and throw it at the back of your head, Bernadette, to get you to stop preaching. Because some churches have that problem. And the members really don't care what the preacher got to say. If it feel good, taste good, smell good, then preacher, you shut up. I'm just here to get my groove on. Well, I want to tell you what happened to the children of Egypt when they came out of Egypt and they were at the foot of Sinai. What they did was reach back to all of the filthy things that they had learned in Egypt. They had learned already because the pharaohs had been consulting with demons. That's why they dressed the way they dressed and talked the way they talked, because they had familiar spirits. They figured this out. You know, think about this now. The same region of our brain that gets excited doing eating also gets excited when you hear music. The same region of our brain that gets excited doing intimacy. Can I say it that way? It's the same region that's touched by music. The same region of our brain that gets excited when we get the victory gets excited over music. So what the devil says is, I'll turn the lights down low. Everybody get closer. Lord have mercy. And he combines the food, the music, and the drama. And then we call it church. I know it was church because I felt it. I know it was church because I was out of control. When I got to shouting, I could not control myself. Well, it was a spirit, but that doesn't mean it was the Holy Spirit. If you're listening to the wrong things, then you're going to get the wrong answer. It's like going and asking the devil, is this of the Lord? What you think he's going to say? He's going to say, yes, of course it is. But then what happens is our palates change and it becomes difficult to get excited about God because we live in a realm that's excited about the devil. All of a sudden now, because we have not monitored or had good stewardship over our behavior, then God can't reach us and we can't be saved. So it's critical now that when we see the sissy switching up to the keyboard, somebody got to say something. Lord have mercy. And if it's not a sissy, if it's the gigolo pimping up to the keyboard, going up there looking like Denzel, all the sisters on the front row trying to get his attention, somebody who is filled with the Holy Spirit ought to say something. So, well, if somebody grabs that mic and wants to lead out, they may sing like an angel. But if they're full of hell, somebody ought to say something. Because we're supposed to be a watchman on the wall, because we're supposed to be God's anointed, we can't get shaky now. Oh, we Super Bowl at the dinner table when it's time to vote and say, get them up out of here for their own salvation. Because there are people lost in church because people have co-signed their foolishness in order to exercise their talent. Lord, have mercy. I don't know what's wrong with a church that serves up its children to a gifted pedophile. Somebody ought to say something. Lord have mercy. I think we're in, as my wife said, a cold blue. When I look around and I see some people worshiping, the spirit is high, and we see folk who God done brought them over so many troubled waters, they ought to be running around the church and sitting there with their arms folded. Talking about it's too loud in here. She need to sit down somewhere. I don't know why he up every Sabbath. Why don't he shut up? In the meantime, with your grumpy self, kids are being lost all around you because you're giving them permission not to worship in the house of the Lord because you're listening to the wrong spirit. If the Spirit of God is moving, it ought to hit you first. If everybody else is a heathen, at least you ought to worship. If they're fake worshiping, you ought to be worshiping for real. If they're pretending, you ought to be authentic. Now, I'm only saying this stuff because in a little while, folks who don't know no better are going to come to our meeting. And I'm going to get a Holy Ghost fly swatter for the people with that nasty look on their face and all that. Why they come dressed like that? And why they, oh, I'm gonna call you by name. I promise you I'll do it. Everything all right, sister so-and-so? You mad about these heathen coming listening to a word, but you wasn't mad about heathen serving as officers in your church. You wasn't mad when all them heathens was up in there leading out and you know they full of hell. You ain't say nothing about that. But folks who are dirty, lost, looking for salvation, looking for hope, you got a problem with that? Some of y'all will let the devil pastor if you can get a cut. The Then when folk come off the street, all of a sudden you got righteous indignation. Now you mad. You ain't been mad for the last 20 years. We ain't been able to get nothing right, stuff out of sort, devil just floating around in the church. You ain't mad about that. You know it's better not to have no music at all than to have the devil leading out. Look at John 4. It says, John 4:23, thank you, Holy Spirit, for moving the rain. I see sunshine. Amen. John 4:23 says, but a time is coming and has now come when the what kind of worshiper? Oh, you better ask yourself, Lord, am I a true worshiper? The true worshiper will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. You got spirit, but do you have the truth? You got spirit, but if you got aught with your brother and you will not resolve it, you don't have the truth. Lord have mercy. You got spirit, but if you're clicking up, ganging up, and loading up, and locking up, if you got your spiritual Holy Ghost Glock and your P9 ready to blow somebody away, you might have had spirit. And I love the last part of John 4:23, for the Father is seeking such as these to worship him. Verse 24, God is what? A spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Ain't no coming to God half done. I know, help me, Lord. He worked that one out right there in real time. I almost said something else. Ain't no coming to God half done. You got to come to God with a sincere heart that we might worship him. And if somebody is seeking God, the rest of us, Angela, ought to show them the way, not through our talk, but through our walk. They ought to see us worshiping God in such a way that they would want to worship him too. You got to make it okay to worship God in his tabernacle. Now, I know that some of you are the remnant out of the remnant out of the remnant. You're halfway shepherd rod, halfway Adventist. But let me tell you that the Bible says make a joyful noise. Uh-huh. And so I know that you are so, your diet is so pure that you just pee air. But if you don't have no joy, you just got a clean system with no Jesus, because God is spirit. Now, how you going to go through all of that and be mad? All that preparation for glory. I mean, you whistle clean. You got baby's breath. And talking nasty to people. Here's Philippians 3, verse 3. For we are the circumcision. You see that? We are the circumcision which worship God in spirit and rejoice in Christ Jesus and have no confidence in the flesh. I'm just saying that for the remnant out of the remnant out of the remnant. Ain't but two of them left. They hanging on to one another. It's okay to question the flesh. The flesh is what got you messed up now. It's what got you where you are. As a matter of fact, it should be a reasonable expectation to question the decisions you're about to make. It should be a reasonable expectation to question the atmosphere. Because if sound is vibration moving on a frequency, then it is something that you don't just hear. Is something that goes in you. Yes. If it's riding on the wind, if it's riding on a frequency, let me prove it to you. Somebody could be having a great day and somebody can say one thing to mess up your whole month. Amen. You didn't just hear it, it went in you. And now you're gonna pray to Jesus to try to get it out of you. So my suggestion is hang around folks who don't put wicked stuff in you. Yeah, some of us want to make friends so bad. We want to be buddies so bad that we on a freight train to hell with them. I mean, you so messed up, you scratching and itching, your internals are bleeding, and you still want to hang on and be with them no matter what. You got headaches, your feet itching, your toes curling, and you still, well, that's my friend. We're not supposed to have any confidence in the flesh. I'm getting ready to go. I told you it was going to be a short one. I hope you, I didn't put you to sleep. But this is our battle. This is our battlefield. Because the devil has figured out how to bypass parents. We crying and praying, crying and praying and crying. I mean, things have changed. They have changed. When the older kids were little, boom, knock them out. You wake up, you remember what I said. And then they wouldn't do it no more. But not these kids. These kids look at you to make you lock your door, sleep with a knife under your pillow. Because the devil has figured out how to bypass you. And so now I'm like, well, usually I would get elbow, I'd chin check you. Now I'm thinking, man, we got to pray. Because this is not a flesh issue. This is a spirit that's gone deep down on the inside of them. And I can't win this war with a switch. I can't win it with a belt. I can't win it with a chin check. Now I got to fight on my knees because I'm talking and this child don't even hear what I'm saying. I can see it in their eyes that the devil has them. That's why never again will I pastor a church that ignores the children. Never again will I send them away so the adults can be comfortable. No, they got to get all of Jesus. You got to be where I can see you. You got to be in the house where we, I don't care how mad it make you. I don't care how little it make you feel. I don't care how small. I'm not a kid anymore. No, you 18, but you're going to be sitting right next to me until you leave my house. This is our battlefield. And so what's crazy about it is they're not looking for it, y'all. All they want to do is play a game. And so the left brain is playing the game and the right brain hears the music behind the game. Lord have mercy. Yes, indeed. So I talked to Micah, talked to Micah, talked. Talk to him every chance that we get. I got to drop something godly in his spirit because it's no longer an idea of if it's going to get to him. No, it's already there. You got to get it out of him. And remember earlier we said that as learning a language, the kids receive it like a sponge earlier, but to teach them a different language later is much harder for them to absorb when they would have gotten it as a little child. It's like swimming, right? They would have absorbed it. So later, it's get hard. The longer it goes, the harder it is to hear. And God says in order to be saved, you got to call on him. And you can't call on him unless you hear him. And you can't hear him unless you get the junk out of your ears. You see, the reason the devil loves kids because they don't understand the danger. They don't sense the crisis. They don't know that it's not a guarantee you're going to grow up. It's not a guarantee you're going to make it. It's not a guarantee that when you lose your mind that you're going to come back. They don't know that. So they looking at you like, what's wrong with you? They probably think they know more than we do because they have things we didn't have. That's true. You have stuff I didn't have, but it's the same devil behind the same stuff I had that you have. And so now the enemy is in the house. The enemy is in the house. And he's coaching our children on how to deceive us. Amen. And they get good at it too. But the thing that gives it away is when it's time to worship. You might have tricked me and told me you wasn't listening, you wasn't watching. I ain't paid no attention to that. I didn't receive that. Dad, I know what that is. You might have told me all of that. But when it's time to worship, who your God is revealed. So I don't know what you gonna do, Niecy. I don't know what y'all gonna do. But I'm telling you that me and Sister Hood, we're not giving up without a fight. The problem that I have, Uncle Judge, is that this is a new kind of battle, so I don't know how to fight like I used to. I mean, an uppercut used to do it. But that ain't working today. It just caught a child not too long ago. She had drawn two tombstones on her paper at school. Rest in peace, one for her mother, one for her father. And he looked into it, and the child was actually going to kill their parents. Now, you know, I would never want it to come to anything like that. But I will let my child know what my mama told me. I brought you into the world. I'll take you up out of here. I'm going to cry the whole time. I'm going to cry, Michael. I'm going to cry the whole time. Oh, Lord, I hate it came to this. And I'm going to be choking you while I'm praying. Lord, I hate that it happened this way. But you ain't going to kill me. I'll tell you that right now. Y'all pastor be on the news. Like, y'all seen pastor on the news? He just kept hitting him and hitting him. The police was there and he just kept hitting him. But we got to figure out how to fight this new battle. It's something the world had never seen. It's the Tower of Babel being built again. The devil can communicate to the whole world at one time. And what I want to say to our young people today is no matter how well or how good of an actor you become in your home, it's on the record. Ask some of these older folk around here. We still paying for stuff that we thought we got away with because it caught up with us. When something is on the record and you don't repent and turn from your evil ways, Caleb, it catches up to you. It's going to get you sooner or later. And a lot of times it's sooner than later. And it causes you to pay more than you intended because you weren't thinking when you subscribed. All you were thinking is my friend like it and I want my friend to like me. But I want you to remember it's on the record. What record is that? 1 John 5:7, for there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, meaning Jesus, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. You see, the dangerous thing other than being consumed is that at some point you're going to need the Lord. Lord, have mercy. At some point, the covering of your father and mother are not going to be sufficient because you're going to be in troubled waters by yourself and you're going to need the Lord. And you don't want him to say, I never knew you. You don't want to be in a position where you don't know how to call on Jesus because you was too busy calling on hip hop and reggae and whatever else you was into. And you don't know how to call on. Learn how to call him now. Respect him in your youth and God will take care of you. He winks at your ignorance. He forgives and heals from the guttermost to the uttermost. God will forgive you again and again if you don't know no better. But it's on the record. It's on the record and you're going to need him. Here's Deuteronomy 30:19. I call heaven and earth to what? Record this day against you that I have set before you life and death, blessings and cursings. Therefore choose what? Life, that both thou and who? Thy seed. I'm talking to the parents now. choose life. You know, the Bible says to the father, don't provoke your child to anger. Some of us have sent our child to the devil because every time they came to us, we had the stupid thing that our parents said to them. Amen. Saying things like, because I said so. Get over it. Go on somewhere. Get out of my face. Well, where do you think you're sending them to? Correction is good, but abuse is deadly. When we go beyond correction and we begin to destroy their self-esteem, now they need another father. Now they need another mother who will accept them the way they are, and now they can't hear you. So the Lord is speaking here. He says, I call heaven and earth to record this against you. Life and death is in front of you, mom, dad, guardian, grandparent, auntie, uncle. Life and death is in front of you. And if you are out there doing whatever, if you are displaying the wrong thing in front of this child, if you're not doing what you're supposed to do, you're choosing death. And as an incentive, God threw this in. Choose life, and I'll save you and your children. You say, well, Pastor, it's hard. I'm getting ready to leave. I think I don't have no musician today. But that's all right. Getting ready to go. It's time to worship. You know, I just finished a little revival, and then... Then I did another one the last couple of weeks online. And the main thing there is we need to get back to worship. Amen. You know, we've gotten so many gadgets and toys, and we can predict the weather for months on out. And we begin to think we're self-sufficient. We start to think we can figure everything out. But the real path to holiness is to trust God. And what is the sign that we trust him? We worship him in advance. Before the breakthrough, before the answers, before the deliverance. Lord, I lift you up now. I praise you now. I glorify your name now. I bless your name, Jesus, now. You know, you can help your record by putting some on the record. You can put on the record that in the day of your trouble, you called upon the name of the Lord. In the time of your distress, you called him and trusted him with your life. You can put it on the record. And then later, when our children, when our sons, daughters, nieces, nephew, when they get in trouble, they'll remember the record. When mama was in trouble, she took it to the Lord in prayer. When daddy was down, he went down on his knees and said, Lord, help my unbelief. Put it on the record, because the little things that go into their mind are there forever. Look, I said I wasn't going to go on. Let's pray. Father, thank you for what you have done for us. We only looked at one little body part today. We just looked at the amazing engineering of our ears. Who knew that small little hair follicles are interpreters? They vibrate like Morse code and sends a signal to the brain to make us understand what's being said. Then not only can we receive, but we can project out of our voice box that you are the honor, the power, and the glory. Lord, as we close this message, we desire that everyone in the room get in the fight. Many of us have felt helpless and hopeless. I know I have. The enemy is everywhere. How can I protect my loved ones from the devil when it's everywhere? Then we leave home and come to church, and the devil has made his way into the church. But I believe that you are the power, the honor, and the glory, that nothing catches you by surprise, that nothing the enemy comes up with can supplant what you wrote in Romans 10, that if we call upon the name of the Lord, we shall be saved. Perhaps there's someone here today who heard what was prayed, heard what was preached, and you heard this prayer, and you need to make your calling and election sure. Maybe you have, the light came on for you today, and you realize, wait a minute, God is spirit, and I've been trying to win this battle in the flesh. I laughed at Pastor Hood, but I know he was telling the truth. The devil has infiltrated so much that a whipping, a spanking is not going to do it. There must be spiritual warfare. And while I was thinking about the children, I considered myself that I am engaged in some of these things that have me trapped and stuck, and it's hard for me to worship. If that's you, there's no shame in it unless you don't come. If you come to the Lord, it's all washed away. And you begin anew. Instead of you just fighting the fight, you have the Spirit of the living God assisting you, because you took away the stumbling block. You took away the barrier that was preventing you and God to make an agreement that we shall not fall. See, he's able to keep you from falling. But if you have a stumbling block between you and God, then he can't stop you from falling. You have to give him permission. Will you come today and give God permission? Will you give God permission to help you with your issues? He knows the power of music. He knows that we are subject to it. So we have to be subject to a greater power. Will you do that today? Will you come? Will you come? Thank you, Lord. We have done what we were supposed to do. Now, Lord, I pray for each and every one of us, starting with my household. Everything that we want to do, everything that we try to do, the devil wants to be in the background, teaching his doctrine through clothing, through dress, through language, through that talk, the way people talk, through the way that people deal with one another, and of course the music, the movies, the video games. He's trying to find his way into everything. So Lord, I pray that you put a hedge around my home. And then Lord, from there you go out to each home represented here. Lord, you know that we need some help. It's not that we haven't been trying, but it's the fight of our lives to try to keep these kids safe and also keep our minds right. Oh, it's more than a notion, but help us, Lord, and bless us. And we'll be careful to give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you so much. We were right on time. We did have a, I think somebody, we need to check the weather again. But we did have play rehearsal. We're just going to do that on Thursday with our full sound effects. Let's do a dress rehearsal on Thursday night. I know that there was Pathfinder meeting at 2. I don't know what if the weather patterns have changed since I've been up here. But if they have not, you got to tell me. You got to check. Let's use wisdom. Look at the rest of the day. If there's a chance that is going to be trouble, I suggest that we postpone that to another time. All right, I'm going to turn the service back over to Elder Parker. God bless you and thank you, and may he keep you in the palm of his hands.
Amen. Let's give God a hand clap of praise for the word on this morning. We need the word to help us to get ready to hear the voice of the Lord when he says, come up hither. And as the pastor said, unless we are in the right spirit, we will not be able to hear that voice. Amen. Amen. We thank you for being with us on today. We have four ways to give. You can leave it in the box out on the wall in the parking lot. You can leave it in here. You can mail it in. Or you can call one of the elders to come by and pick it up, and we'll be glad to do that for you. All you have to do is let us know. Those are the four ways to give. And we thank you for being with us this morning, asking that you have a blessed day. And remember that there is prayer every morning, Monday through Sabbath, and then Sunday night we have prayer also. Pastor said already, we need to pray. Pray for our children, pray for ourselves. And that's a way we can pray together. So just look at the little card that you have, or just contact somebody and say, hey, what's the numbers that I can get on to pray? And remember, Tuesday night, Wednesday night, we also have Bible study. So you can come on Bible study also on Zoom. Second Sabbath, fourth Sabbath, last day events. You can come on there to learn also. There's so many ways we can learn how to get closer to God. All we have to do is connect up with one another and then connect up with God. Amen? Amen. God bless you. The ushers will usher you out. Remember to be safe going home and continue to pray for one another. God bless you.